what is wrong with the establishment is we have had now two and three generations of the constitutional dumbing down of this country, and this notion that everybody is a victim, particularly if you're a person of color, everybody's a victim, and government will solve all of the problems for you. It's come home to roost. It's come a cropper. It didn't happen overnight. Just as, you know, one would yearn for the days if we had an attorney general who was actually going to Ferguson to assist law enforcement, to denounce lawbreakers, to denounce rioters, and yet we have is we have an attorney general going around to churches talking about what we need to do within government to address these problems of racial profiling. Racial profiling has nothing to do with what's going on in Ferguson, other than from the standpoint of the racial race baiting by Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson and so forth. And yet we have the entire institution of the federal government on the opposite side. This administration is not going to change. The leadership in the Congress does not appear ready, willing, and able to change. But ultimately, I still am optimistic. I think there are enough good people, some of them new people, in the House and the Senate on the Republican side, that they will make sure that some things are done. I'm not overly optimistic, but I do believe that that we are going to see enough people stand up so that we will start to turn this thing around.
And there are cases where the police clearly do beat and shoot black people, you know, to death for no reason. And those are real cases. And a lot of times the police get indicted. But there's also cases where they kill white people the same way. It's just this case is one of the worst ones to pick when all the evidence points towards Brown being a thug. I'm sad he's dead. We're going to talk about the case of Eric Garter here in a minute, choked to death up in New York in Staten Island. And it does look like manslaughter to me. But still, different black leaders saying, you know, go out and kill some white people. It's just wild that there are folks that really want to have a race war in this country, and it just shows how hatred can be in every different, quote, group. Bob Barr, thank you for the time.
Thank you very much, Alex. LibertyGuard.org, and I look forward to being with you again in the near future.
Yes, sir. Thanks for coming on with us. Well, there goes Bob Barr.